Hello friends, hope you're all safe and well in the current situation. Quite some time, sorry for that, I was a bit busy. So this will be very interesting. In this video, I'll show you how to draw a 4-dimensional and a 5-dimensional cube, hypercube rather. This area is mainly abstract mathematics, I would say, but there are many applications in physics, in modern physics. Kaluza Klein concept for one, string theory for another, and many more. So of course, it's pretty difficult to visualize these things. And obviously, it's very easy to generate these things. You can see many computer generated graphics and GIFs, how these transformations take place. But I'll not be showing those things to you here. I'll just tell you how to, give you some tricks, how to draw it easily. Well, now you may ask that, what will I do by drawing those things? Nothing, but it can give you some pleasure. At best, it can impress your math teacher, for instance. Because it's really interesting, right? And there are some tricks. I'll try to make you visualize the thing, as best as I can. So first of all, there is one very important trick, not exactly trick. For instance, I have So let's have two lines here, right? So if I join these two lines using two other lines, then I get sort of a square, right? So I don't know whether there is any material in my argument, but I'm just showing it. I'm just telling it to you. So basically, the pen is a bit not working properly. So basically, there are two lines. You are joining two one-dimensional lines by using two other lines to get a two-dimensional figure. That is this square. Similarly, if I have two such squares, right, then you will need four lines basically. You see, four lines. To join these two squares, to connect these two squares into a 3D figure, 3-dimensional cube, so 2, 4. Similarly, if I draw a 4-dimensional hypercube, you will see that there are 6 lines connecting two cubes. I think you get the idea. So, it may be the case that there are 8 lines, but anyway, it's a bit, a bit difficult to visualize this thing. And also one more thing, when you're seeing a cube, right, when you're dealing with a cube, see, basically it looks like this, right, This is what it looks like. Now, I am drawing in yellow those the other lines, but these things are it's not always visible. I'm just drawing the main outline is in the one drawn in the red. And you see, if you count the number of red lines, you see it will be 6, right? 1 here, 2, 3, 4, 5 here, and 6. 6 red lines, right? Square, it's 4 for square, it's alright, just 4. And 4, 6, I think you get the idea. And similarly, if you see for a 4, 6 and x is 8, if you see for a hypercube, the shape is like an octagon. I'm talking about the shape, okay, I'm not drawing the hypercube, doesn't look like this, it's a way more complex figure. For the shape, it's like an octagon. And for a 5-dimensional cube, this is a 4-dimensional cube basically, this is 4D. For a 5D cube, you see the shape will be a dodecagon, there will be 10 sides. Okay, so let's see how a 4-dimensional hypercube looks like. So we all know that it's pretty easy to generate such figures, using computers and all. But I would like to make you learn how to draw it by your hand, because that's not important in today's world of computers. That's nothing important, but that's a beautiful trick anyway. So what if you first of all, just make a 3x3 pattern, grid sort of. Okay, but don't connect a 3x3 matrix, but don't connect the outsides. Okay, the boundaries you don't connect. By the way, I must warn you that this pen is a bit malfunctioning, so I'll only be able to show you a rough figure, because this is just a freehand diagram, you understand. So next, you will just do what I'm doing here, okay, just join this thing. Basically, there will be 4 crosses in these 4 boxes, okay. In the middle boxes, if you consider this row, then this is the middle row, not exactly box, the middle one, I think you understand. And such that they'll all be joined. You get the idea. This is so far so good, because this is a trick. Otherwise, if you try to draw 2 cubes and then connect them in the right way so that you can get a hypercube, that is a bit difficult to draw, right? So better follow this trick. I think so far so good. Now what you will do? Do this. Okay. These two lines should be parallel, this and this should be parallel. I think you get the idea. Obviously, everything should be parallel here, like these things, but it's a bit difficult to draw since I'm drawing it like freehand diagram. Now you see, I think you can visualize the shape of an octagon. Now you have to obviously you have to join these boundaries, and all, this is a regular octagon, so all these lines should be equal, but obviously they are not equal. Okay, but you get the idea, like the basic idea of how this shape looks like. Right, that's the octagon. So almost complete, except we do a few more things, and that is to just join this line here, this line here. So you, I think you can see a this sort of pattern here, right in the middle, this sort of pattern, right here, and these crosses are there. I'm not marking them here. So from both that, both from all these four points, these points have to join these things of the octagon. Okay, that's what I'm doing here, nothing here. And similarly, a same pattern you will see, but like in this orientation, so do the same thing here. Okay? And your hypercube is complete. So try to visualize this a bit. See, I'm actually you can see two cubes. Okay, I'm just marking the bound. Oh, sorry, extremely sorry. Yeah, I'm just marking the boundary of the cube so that you can see what I mean. You see this thing I'm bound, I'm just shading in yellow. See this is a cube, right? I think you can make it out. So this rectangle is a cube. Now the other cube, let me do it in blue. So this is another cube, right? Now I think you can easily visualize one yellow cube and one blue cube. And you see there's a bit of overlapping. I'm just showing this to you in this green color thing. So see there's a bit of overlapping between these two cubes. I think you understand what I mean. These two cubes are like not exactly overlapping, yeah, like sort of, you know what I mean. And then you have to join some lines. Now you just recall what I just told you, that two lines you can join using two other lines to get a square. These are the other lines, I'm marking them like this. Similarly, two squares you can use, you can make it into a cube or cuboid, doesn't matter, by using four lines. So joining four lines basically, right? Similarly, here we have these two cubes. Those two cubes we already have, so not a problem. Other than that, you see there are six lines. One here, these green ones. Two, three, four, five, six. And also there are these lines here. I mean, but these lines are already a part of a cube, obviously. So you have to consider only those lines which are not the edge of these two cubes. So see, there are only two more lines actually, this here and this here. Rest all lines are the edge of a cube. It's a bit hard to visualize. I know if you're seeing this for the first time, it's definitely hard to visualize. I do understand. So see, basically you're getting these lines. One, two, three, four, five. So actually eight lines you're getting, right? And well, obviously this is again obvious because not obvious, but this is seem to get some sort of pattern because here we had four lines. So four is two raised to power two, and eight is two raised to power three. So maybe there are 16 lines joining two hypercubes, like two four-dimensional hypercubes into a five-dimensional cube. Who knows? Anyway, I'm not an expert on this field. I love playing with this thing. So first of all, this is a very simple trick to draw a hypercube, a four-dimensional hypercube. This was a four-dimensional one. Okay. So I'm just going over it in very short, like once. Just oh sorry. Just do this. This. If you watch it twice, then you'll be able to understand it better because this is a simple trick. Because if you try to draw two cubes and then figure out what to join and what to not, then that will be a bit difficult. It's comparatively easier to draw it using this, right? Just this, and then you join all these things. Okay, so this is your hypercube. Obviously, my figure is like this is a freehand diagram. And now let's see what a five-dimensional cube looks like. Okay. So obviously, as I told you once before also, let me make it very clear that these figures which I am drawing, okay, you are only seeing the cube at an appropriate angle such that it appears octagon to you or an octagon. This figure looks good, right? But doesn't matter if I, like for instance, if I see a cube, a three-dimensional cube, the normal one, okay, if I see it from the very front, then it just looks like a square, right? Okay, that's the thing. But if I see it from other angles, it looks somewhat like this, right? So that is the point. So these, so obviously there are many different orientations, and as far as I did a bit of study, so I found this was the easiest to draw. That's why I have figured out some tricks like how to draw these things. Not that this is anything useful, but fun. So for the third one, like for the this is a bit more tricky, obviously, but anyway, five dimensional cube. First of all, you draw a regular dodecagon. That means a regular polygon with 10 sides, 10 equal sides rather. So basically, you draw a circle, not draw a circle, I'm just showing you the basic example. Circle, this is the diameter, okay? So just divide this semicircular arc, okay, this thing, into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? And this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is how your dodecagon looks like. Anyway, circle can be approximated to be a polygon with infinite sides, right? So more the number of sides, more it resembles a circle, right? So it's a bit difficult to draw, especially as this pen is malfunctioning a bit, but I'll try my best. And again, this figure will only be an approximate one because I'm drawing it in freehand, okay? 1, 2, 3. And yeah, it should be symmetric. Obviously, it will be symmetric because it's a regular one. It must be symmetric. Okay, so this is a crude drawing, obviously. It's not a very good drawing because, as I told you, but anyway, so this is our, let's say this is our dodecagon, the rough idea to draw. Now what you have to do very careful, see very carefully and bring it in your locus so that you understand. The trick is very simple, okay? You just join the opposite, like sort of, you just do this, join the opposite vertices basically. And now, connecting the vertices of the dodecagon, there can be only two more lines which are parallel to this yellow line. So how many lines can be there such that like those lines should join two vertices of this polygon? So one this and one this. If you try to join any two other set of vertices, then they will not be parallel to the middle line at all. So done. Next, you join this line here. So again, there will be two lines, this here and this here, which will be parallel to this one. And then you join this line here, and again there will be, I think the trick is easy to follow, this here and this here. As for the dodecagon, you are almost done, but wait. So far, so good. Now you have to draw the diagonal, you have to like join these things. Okay, do this and do this. Now I'll tell you what I mean. Let me first draw, okay? Okay, I think you get the idea. Yeah. Another thing is that I just want to tell you that these things you are seeing, right? Like these sort of trapeziums, right? This is sort of trapezium here. So the diagonals of these trapeziums must be there. See, you have a diagonal here also, like approximately, okay? The diagonals and then diagonals. Understand what I mean? Okay. That's great. Now what you will do? You have to like extend these lines outwards. Okay. Now how will you do this? There is a simple trick for that. You will get a dodecagon on the outside also. That's a trick. So now obviously this line you can extend easily. So are you getting a dodecagon? Now see, if I join, I'm just doing this. Okay, if I join this line, one side, two, three, four, five, six, I get a hexagon. So I'm not getting a dodecagon. That means there should be something else. And what is that? Okay, yeah. Like even if you forget to do something, you get the idea. Now what you have to do, you join this thing here and this thing here. These things also you had to join. I forgot to tell you. Okay, now you see if you extend these lines, now I think you will get a dodecagon. Yeah. So let me join this, and this should be regular. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you're getting a dodecagon on the outs, like this external figure, this big one is also a dodecagon. That's great. That should be the case. Now you're almost done, about 70% of the figure is done, I dare say. Okay. So now what you will do is that let me choose this purple one. Now the pattern is very simple, but still I would like to show you something so that like Consider this slice. Like this dodecagon basically has 10 such sizes. Not exactly a pizza size or something, because this is not an arc. Like this is not a circle, okay? You get what I mean, right? So that's important here. So in this slice you consider, suppose this is one side of the inner dagagon, that's the smaller dagagon, and this is the side of the larger dagagon. So see, in the inner one, I already told you that you will have this thing, and here was an intersection, right? I think you can see. This trapezium will have the diagonals, right? I already told you. And you can see also, right? So now what you will do is that you just make a this sort of pattern, okay? Just join this here and join this here, such that this line should be parallel to this line. But you don't have to join this line, okay? Don't join this line. Wait, yeah. And now you do this, join this to this here and that here. I think you get the idea. Like, and this thing will kind of, you'll do this only twice. Like, you'll not do this infinitely. Okay, here, then here. No, not infinitely. I mean, only twice. Okay. The smaller dagagon has already, in the smaller dagagon, these things are already done. Like, the diagonals of the trapezium already done. So for this part, I'm just shading this one so that you can understand. For this part for all the cases. Okay. You will do this only twice. Now I think you get the idea, and it will be more clear to you as I draw. Okay. Yeah. So let's. Oh, sorry. So let's see this here. Then you join this, and you join this. I think you get the idea that my drawing is a bit. Anyway. Now this here. And this here, so I meant this line, okay, this line here, sorry, this line to be parallel to this line. That's what I meant. So you should draw like that. Like you should, figure should be like, you know, the both these lines should be regular. You understand what I mean? So you should draw like this here. And you can do this same thing for all. I'm just doing this quickly and obviously like a freehand diagram, but I think you'll get what I mean. Now this is only the trick. But ultimately you have to visualize, okay, and that is the more difficult, more tricky part. Yeah, anyone can follow such simple rules and draw the figure. Drawing, yeah, that's not even drawing is unimportant because we have computers for that. But the trick is important. I mean, visualization is important. You have to visualize how this is coming. Okay. Yes. Now I think it must be clear to you what I'm doing after seeing so many moves. So yeah, this is how our hypercube looks like. Now it's looking a bit dirty in this part, so let me just correct this. Okay, this part I'm talking about, yeah. So I think you get the idea. Now this is the, it looks like this, obviously. Now I can try to make you visualize a little things, but obviously this is a 5D figure, so you can understand. Pretty complex. And anyway, we are not used to these things. So there are some limitations in our mind also. Right. Okay. So I am trying to, actually this is a bit colorful figure, so it will be difficult to visualize, but I'm trying my best. Okay. See, I'm just shading this out. I think it will make it. If you see nicely, you can make out many cubes in this room, like many three-dimensional cubes, normal cubes in this figure. Okay. Obviously, as because it's a freehand diagram, I have not drawn it like very nicely or very impressively or something, but I think you can make out that this is a cube, right? Like there are more. You can make out a cube like this. I think you get which cube I'm talking about. Yes. And there will be some cubes here also. There are many cubes in this figure actually. It's a bit confusing because these cubes are overlapping, right? So to visualize them is like it's a great feat actually. I think you see a cube there, I think, because well anyway. And I think you'll see a cube here also. Okay, like yes. Like these two cubes are a bit overlapping. I think you can see a cube here also. And so, like it's really interesting to play with these figures. Okay. And obviously, this is a very important field in mathematics. Okay. It's not just like beautiful patterns or something. This here is another cube, if I'm not much mistaken. So, difficult to, you know. Yeah, this cube I'm talking about. These two, so there should be a cube here also, a bit slanted. Yes, and I see it now. Oh, sorry. Yeah, no, that's all right. Okay, no problem. So this cube I'm talking about, I think you get it, right? This cube. Yes. So you already figured out about like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 cubes, I think. 6 cubes we figured out. Maybe there's a relation, like in this dimensional figure cube there will be six, or like there will be this number of three-dimensional cubes or something like that. Oh, I see one right here also. So now let's do it in a bit different color because it's getting a bit confusing, right? In yellow, let's try it out once. This cube, okay? This one here, this one here, this one. But again, yellow, the center is also yellow, so you'll get confused. Yeah, not a problem. Well, let's use black one, not a problem. Like this cube I'm talking about, okay? You understand? This cube here, this cube, we have not shaded this out. We have not shaded this out. And this one here. Very, very confusing actually. It looks dirty also. And similarly, there will be this cube symmetric to this, okay? And you can, there you get, I'm finding it pretty difficult to shade this out. 8 cubes, we figured out. And obviously, there will be those, actually 10 cubes because corresponding to those cubes, there will be those cubes on here also. I think so. Okay, so. So in this figure also you can see more than 2 cubes. Okay, to be nice to visualize because I showed you only 2 cubes in right. But in this figure also see if you observe there will be more than 1 cubes, like more than 2 cubes. Obviously we have these cubes here. Let's just like highlight them once more. This cube here and corresponding to it like this cube here aligned at the same angle. Okay, that's what we find similar between these 2 cubes. And then you'll find one more pair. Okay, I am talking about, now let's do it in a different color. I am talking about this cube here. Now I think you can visualize it easily because we are doing it in a different color. This cube here, right? So I think you can visualize this. And corresponding to this, you see another cube, like just facing in the opposite direction, but like similar in dimensions. Okay, I think you see this cube one here, right? Like visualize one is like this and one is like this. You understand? And so basically, I could tell you one thing. So basically, this thing is common between both of these cubes. So I can draw it here so that you feel comfortable. Like just for you, this is a cube, resembles a cuboid more like a cube, but don't mind. I just okay. So one is like this, and another one is like this, like the same dimensions. You can understand from the same. Okay, you can forget this part. Okay. Okay. So the same one. I think you can understand, right? This sort of similarity from the but like that was the above part, not actually above, okay. But anyway, from this part also, see, we can actually draw 2 cubes. One is this cube here. Okay, let's not do this in blue this time. We will use red this time. Yeah. So, okay, this part, I think you can make it out. That's the beauty of colors. By the way, one interesting thing, even colors can help you determine dimensions. For instance, I read it somewhere. Like it was a very good thing actually. You know, there was a ribbon. It was shaped like infinity. Like it was like it was curled like bent in this shape and it was there. Now this part was colored differently. Let's see. This part was colored a bit differently. Anyway, so that it created actually the ribbon was black colored. Okay, let's like it was not red colored. Okay. It's actually black colored. And then you colored this part white, like this part. So it created the illusion that this part is overlapping on the other part. Right. So overlapping means you get a sense of a higher dimension space, right? High dimension space obviously on a it's a bit hard to visualize on a two-dimensional paper. But a slight change in color can actually make you do so. That is the point. Colors can help you visualize these things very nicely. Now you can easily visualize these 2 blue cubes and 2 red ones, the other one I'm drawing right now, okay? And the 2 yellow ones. So actually there are 6 cubes here. Right. Are there any more cubes? Right, so this is basically a four-dimensional cube, and we found that it has 6 cubes, so that is 4 plus 2 is 6, right? And in that case we found out around many cubes we found out. So like 8 or something. So anyway, I think you found the video interesting, and that is the concept of higher dimensional cubes. It's very interesting, and you can check out 6 dimensional or 7 dimensional or even higher, because obviously it's a much more complex topic. Now I remember that I recapped the 4 dimensional cube once quickly, so let's do so for the 6 dimensional one also, for the 5 dimensional one also, once very quickly. So first of all you have to do is draw a 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, draw a regular dodecagon. Obviously it's not a regular one, but never mind. Okay, this thing here, these three parallel set of lines, this here and this here. This here, right? And don't forget this here, this here, this and this. So that these diagonals of the trapezium will intersect here. I think this trapezium I'm talking about, I think you understand. And this, this. So far so good. Yeah, correct. Now just extend them. You again get a dodecagon. This is the magic of dimensions, that basically you are getting a, like, you know what I mean? Or maybe red.
Yeah.
You will be able to see many shadows and so on in higher dimensions. You can read Dr. Mishokaku's book, Hyperspace. There he has given many examples and like he has understood the concept very nicely. Again, let's use yellow here. Now all you need to do is this thing here. And do the same thing again, but let's still do it, because if you have the patience to watch, I think, and if you really want to practice drawing these things more, the number of times you watch will be beneficial for you. Okay. Oh, sorry. Yeah, so this is basically how your 5 dimensional cube looks like. So 5D cube. So that's all for today's video. I'll try to come up with more interesting videos in the future, and please subscribe to my channel if you like. So thank you for watching and stay safe. Thank you very much.